Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the person drawing in this video. For today's video, I will discuss the right metrics of a hand in iconography and specifically the blessing hand as it appears in the icon of Jesus Pantocrator and other saints. So for drawing this hand, as you see here, I take freely a length to draw the thumb. This length here is doesn't matter how long it is, and I draw the thumb. In the middle of this length, I will draw the joint of the finger, as you see here. And on the edge of this thumb, I will take one more length, one more measurement, as you see here. And I will begin to draw the main hand. Here you see me taking this length, drawing the length one part, that is the length of the thumb, from the inner side of the thumb. So I divide this length in half to find the joint of the thumb, and then I divide again the first half. I will divide it again in half, as you see me here doing. At the same time, I can do some corrections if I want. Anyway, from the one half of the first part, as you see here, I will take one length towards the left, and from the bottom part of that first part, I will take one length and a little bit more, and I will find the length of the palm, as you see here. Maybe the way I'm explaining it is confusing, but if you just notice what I'm doing, you will understand what I'm doing. Then, from that length, I will divide it in four, as there are four more fingers to draw. And from the bottom, from the base of the first division, I will take one more length, and I will find the edge, the end of the little finger. So the length of the little finger is the same length as the inner part of the thumb. When I'm drawing the fingers, I have to see these four divisions that I have calculated, and draw the fingers accordingly. So then I will continue drawing the other finger, and I will divide the inner side of that finger in three parts. Each part is a part of the inner side of the finger. There. Then I will continue to my third finger. I have to understand that this drawing might be in the Byzantine iconographic style, but it still refers to the anatomy. And I will take one more part from the top of that second finger, and I will find the length of the middle finger, as you see here. I think that maybe it's better if you mute my comments and you just see me drawing. I think you will understand better just by watching the video. But anyway, I will continue commenting here and see if I will help some people. And then I will take one more length from the little finger towards the top right of the drawing, and this will give me the almost the end of the index finger, almost. It's one length and a little bit more. And as you see, most of the drawing of the fingers is done. I will also draw a little bit the fingers, the nails. The fingers end in pointy edges. And of course, not every hands are absolutely the same, but this is a general approximate metrics that I use for when drawing fingers and hands. If I take a horizontal line from the base of my thumb, and I will find the beginning of my wrist and a little bit lower. And from that point, the beginning of the wrist, here you see me taking this horizontal line and a little bit lower, and I will find the beginning of my wrist. And from that point, I will take a diagonal, approximate diagonal one part. And this will give me the end, the edge of the palm on the base of the hand. Hands are hard to draw. They require that you have drawn some hands from nature, I think, and it can be confusing for beginner iconographers, but the more you practice and the more you understand, the better you will become. Keep in mind that hands have to comply with basic human anatomy, and although they might seem that their position is strange, they have to refer to the real hands. Here I will draw you a finger just to explain you what happens with the joints and the knuckles. The outer part of the finger is divided in unequal parts. The part that is closer to the nail is smaller than the middle knuckle, let's say, the middle part, and that part is smaller than the base of the finger, as you see here. These three parts are not equals, and but on the inner side of the finger, the joints create equal parts. This first part that is closer to the nail is almost equal to the second part, which is again equal to the third part. I hope this makes sense. Try to understand this by observing your own fingers and your own knuckles and joints. And apply this principle to the drawings in your artwork. So this is for the most part the basic metrics of a hand, of a blessing hand. I really hope that you'll find this video helpful. It's a quick one. And here you see me again finding these parts. Again, thank you all so much for participating in this forum, this community. It's really nice to communicate with you. And I would like to thank you all for subscribing and for supporting this channel with your comments and questions. I would like to thank you again and hope that you will paint very well this week as well. Have a blessed day and a blessed week, and I will see you again soon with another tutorial. Be well. Bye.